Waters explains why ion mobility mass spectrometry and collision cross-section are important to your analyses. Meet Dave, an analytical scientist. On a daily basis, he and his associates use mass spectrometry to obtain results from a multitude of samples. One of their challenges is an inconsistency in results due to variations in the complexity and type of samples that they analyze. He heard about how other labs use ion mobility mass spectrometry to enhance their workflows and make use of collision cross-section data. But how will an ion mobility-enabled instrument benefit his lab? And what are collision cross-section data? Dave enlists the help of Meg, a research scientist, to clarify. Meg explains that mass spectrometers separate compounds by their mass-to-charge ratio. Ion mobility is a technique that separates ions by their size, shape, and charge. So using liquid chromatography ion mobility mass spectrometry means Dave will achieve better separation of his samples, giving him confident identification and quantification of analytes. Here's how it works. During an analysis, ions are driven through a gas-filled chamber using an electric field and separate by their size and charge. The ions also separate based on their shape, with the more compact ions traveling quicker than the ones with an open structure. Meg adds that collision cross-section, or CCS, data can be obtained through some ion mobility experiments. It is the effective area for the interaction between an individual ion and a neutral gas molecule. It can be related to important differentiating characteristics of an ion, like its chemical structure and dimensions. There are a few different types of ion mobility, adds Meg, and not all of them provide CCS data. Collision cross-section can be derived using drift tube ion mobility measurements. Typically, multiple measurements are made at different electric fields to calculate the CCS value, which can be time-consuming. Differential IMS, which improves separation by only allowing selected ions to be transmitted one at a time, does not give CCS values. And traveling wave IMS, which maintains sensitivity even at high data acquisition rates. Traveling wave IMS is calibrated for CCS, allowing Dave to obtain CCS values while conducting his routine mass spectrometry analysis. Meg adds that calibration is straightforward and, on some instruments, automatically done for you. It is performed using compounds of known CCS to calibrate the ion mobility chamber. The drift times of the compounds of interest are then converted to CCS values. So how can ion mobility and CCS data help Dave's lab operation? Meg explains that in using ion mobility mass spectrometry, Dave will be able to interpret his results with ease as cleaner spectra are generated. The additional CCS data will give Dave more confidence in his results. On top of that, CCS is matrix and chromatography independent, so Dave can be sure that he gets the same CCS results for every analysis, unlike retention times, which can shift. So with CCS, Dave will reduce false positives and false negatives, so he can have more confidence in his results. Thanks to Meg, Dave now has a great understanding of ion mobility and the benefits of using collision cross-section data. He can't wait to implement ion mobility mass spectrometry in his lab.